Tanzanian football club Young Africans has sacked Belgian coach Luc Eymael after he allegedly made racist and derogatory comments by the country's fans. Eymael was recorded comparing fans to dogs and monkeys following a 1-1 draw last Wednesday. The Tanzanian Football Federation has said it will now take action over the incident, including reporting the former coach to FIFA. Here's CGTN's Daniel Kijo with more.
And favorizing Simba and not giving us...
Luc Eymael was speaking to the media after a contentious game when he made the comments.
Like monkeys, you know, monkeys who are making, or dogs who are biting, you know, blah, 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 blah. They only can
comparing the fans in the stadium to dogs and monkeys. He said they were ignorant about football and that he hated Tanzania. The language has shocked the sports world, which has long struggled to remove racism from the game. He was fired immediately. George Job, a sports analyst with Wasafi Media, says racism creates division and hatred.
A lot of places will ban him for this. Football is a sport that unites a lot of people, and the one thing that everyone tries to discourage is racism. So the example he used to describe the fans was racist in nature, and it created this huge uproar, so much that it overshadowed other parts of what he said, which were true.
Eymael had not issued a response to the allegations and has since returned to Belgium. Before coming to Tanzania to coach the Young Africans, known as Yanga, Eymael had worked in South Africa, Egypt, Algeria, and Tunisia. Analysts say he was known to have a history of making controversial remarks.
We started to hear many things. Rwanda suspended him for 2 years because of some issues with fights. South Africa also doesn't want him. They took him to the FAA. With Tanzania, the same thing. In fact, TFF has taken further actions like escalating the matter to FIFA. So this looks like something that might kill his coaching career.
The Southern African Football Association is also trying to permanently ban Eymael from working in the country. Fans say things need to change.
The problem is they are in a rush, end up going for foreign coaches. Some of these guys don't have discipline because they destroy the reputation of the club, the fans. When they bring in foreign coaches, they should inspect his CV, where he comes from, and the history.
There are many coaches. The management should take time to select the right fit for Yanga. We will get one. Many coaches have come and gone. We need a coach that will leave us well.
Yanga's assistant coach, Charles Boniface Mkwasa, has also requested a break for an unknown period. He has not revealed why he needed the time off, leaving Yanga without a coaching bench. Tanzania's Football Federation is expected to announce the date for the start of the new league. Yanga's management is looking to use this time to rebuild a technical bench that can take them to the top of the league. But with a 20-team league dropping to 18 teams, competition is expected to increase, making the road to the cup even harder. Daniel Kijo, CGTN, Dar es Salaam.